been so many, you know, speculations and rumors. Would you tell us your story about your background?
Like you said, there's a lot of speculations and stuff, and that's what it is. It's the media, you know, like they always do. They just, you know, have these stories.
Information, Courtney, when I was walking in, our producer said that there was a report, Joe Jackson confirming that Michael Jackson has a 25-year-old son.
Yeah, and I called some people close to the family and some family members, and their first response to me was, I was surprised it took this long for this to get out.
They just take it wherever they want it. And I never commented on anything. And it's something that the media creates, and they control it. That's also why I choose not to talk about it. Because at the same time, like, I felt that, you know, you kind of get attacked without, like, you haven't asked, I didn't ask for that type of attention. It just came to me. Like, I want to entertain and, you know, be an artist, but that's my artistic side. Now, what's been exposed out there has been, like, more my personal life. So, like, 90%, more than 90% of my life is made public. And that's why I choose not to talk about, like, the little that I have left. Like, I keep that to myself. So, the media is going to write whatever they choose anyways. I can't control that. So if I say A, they're going to turn that into B. They're going to keep it going. So, you know, that's why I don't give them nothing on that side. They can just keep writing, and that's nothing I can control. I understand that people are curious and they find it interesting. I understand. But I also hope that people understand, like, my side of it, that for me, like, you guys have your private life that you keep to yourself, then there's your work. Mm. For me, my work is, like, my music, my dance. But at the same time, that's personal. So I can talk about that, but then there's that little, like, private life that I want to keep to myself. But of course,
it,
like,
tough.
It's tough, you know? But of course, there's no secret that I'm probably doing what I do today because of him. When it comes to music and dance, like, he taught me so much.
How was he like as a person, would you say?
As of a great, the great artist he was, you know, the most amazing artist of all time, the greatest. I would say he was even greater as a person, as a human being.
Do you have any special memories that from Neverland?
There's so many. We had a lot in common, you know, movies and music and type of food we would like. We like doing pranks, like
any
silly special, silly things like that.
Any prank you remember?
Let me think. There's been a few. There was a few times that I took it a little too far and I got in trouble.
What happened? You must tell me.
No. One time we would have, like, I would be in a hotel, and I would take, like, a lot of tissue, like, paper, and I would soak it up in water, and because I'd be in the hotel and I'd be kind of bored, and I'd soak it up in water, and I would, like, throw it down, and when you're, like, up high in the building, like, when it lands, it's like a big splash, and, like, you make a big mess. So that time, I remember that people of the owners of the hotel, they got kind of upset, and they came up later. But that was my bad. But the other times like that, he would, like, on tour, he would, if there was, like a lot of fans outside waiting, and they would sleep outside, and it was cold, and they would, like, they would be there the whole night, and he would throw down pillows and sheets, you know, so that,
nice.
Yeah, and he would sign them and throw them down.
What do you remember most about it? What do you miss?
I'd rather not go into that. That's okay. Something I'd like to keep to myself. The Invincible album he was kind enough to dedicate to my friend Benjamin Hermanson, who was a friend of mine who was stabbed and killed by Nazis in Norway. He was 15 years old, and so the album was dedicated to him.
Did you practice also a lot with Michael when you were young, dancing?
Yeah. So he's that's things that he told me, like, put your soul into it and, like, really feel it.
Was he good as a teacher?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
you're releasing a single.
Yeah, all around the world.
Can you tell us about it?
The song was written in Norway, and it's for my forthcoming EP, and I did the song over there with a Norwegian producer, and the only thing we were missing was the hook. We had the hook, but I felt that it needed a female vocalist on it, and the first person that popped into my head was Genevieve, and we've been talking about doing something before, so I sent her the track, and I guess she liked it, and then the producer flew over to LA and recorded her part. So yeah, mm-hmm. That's how it was done.
And the pieces come together, right?
And that's how it all came together, mm-hmm. Yeah.
You have been dancing a lot, mm-hmm. since you were very young.
Yeah, I've been dancing basically my whole life.
Mm-hmm. It's a great passion.
Yeah, dancing and music is my passion. It's what I know, so.
Do you remember when you really got inspired and thought dance and singing is for me?
No, like it started so early, but I think it got more serious like when I was around 8 years old, and just watching other artists on TV and concerts, that's like I want to do this, and I just started, you know, practicing at home, like before going to school. I never really took any classes until later when I went to high school, but besides that, I never took classes. It was just practicing in front of the mirror.